friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to the third episode in my WW Instant Pot series. Tonight I'm going to be sharing two delicious chicken recipes with you, one of which is a pasta and the other is chicken over rice. I cannot wait to share these recipes with you. If you are on the fence about buying an Instant Pot, or maybe you have one but you don't use it because you're not sure how to use it, then this is the series for you. I'm going to be sharing two delicious WW-friendly recipes that are so easy to make, one-stop shop in the Instant Pot. So if you want to see what two recipes I have in store for you, all you have to do is stay tuned. For tonight's Instant Pot dinner, we are going to be making Instant Pot buffalo chicken pasta. This sounds so good. Who doesn't love pasta for dinner? So let me show you what is in tonight's dinner. So first you're going to need some pasta. I am using the Fiber Gourmet Light Penne pasta. This pasta is half the smart points of regular pasta, 3 points per 2 ounces versus 6 points per 2 ounces. You can buy this on Amazon and it is linked down in my description box below. This is a staple in my house. I usually have anywhere from 6 to 8 bags on hand. You're also going to need some ranch. So I'm gonna use Bolthouse Classic Ranch. You'll need some hot sauce. So I'm gonna use Sweet Baby Ray's, light butter, bacon bits, cream cheese, light Mexican style or any type of light cheese, and of course some chicken breasts. So let's get started on tonight's dinner. The first step for tonight's dinner is to go ahead and put your 3 breasts of chicken in a Ziploc bag. To that, we are going to add our hot sauce. Now, we don't like our food super spicy, so I'm using half the amount of hot sauce that the recipe called for. And in fact, I'm going to half most of the recipe as well, since there's only 2 people in my family. So this is actually about 1/8 of a cup of hot sauce, and we are just going to put that directly onto our chicken, and then we're just gonna give our chicken a nice good shake, get it nice and covered in the hot sauce, and then we're ready to add some of our ingredients directly into our Instant Pot. So the next step is we are going to take 1 tablespoon of light butter and put that into our Pot, and then to that we are going to go ahead and we're going to add in our pieces of chicken with the hot sauce. Once you've added your light butter and your chicken breast directly into your Instant Pot, we're going to go down here to our dial. We're going to select manual and we are going to up the time to 14 minutes. We'll pop our lid on and we are going to let this cook for 14 minutes. While your chicken is cooking, go ahead and add your cream cheese to a bowl. This is 4 ounces. I did half the amount of cream cheese. I also halved the amount of ranch. So this is 1/2 of a cup of Bolthouse Ranch. And the original recipe also asks that you add additional hot sauce, but I am not going to do that because the hot sauce on the chicken will be enough for us. But you would also add some hot sauce to this mixture. Go ahead and mix together your ranch and your cream cheese until they are fully combined and nice and creamy. Once your chicken is done, you're gonna go ahead and remove it from your Instant Pot. We're gonna add it to a bowl and then we're gonna get it all nice and shredded up. And then we'll add it to our cream cheese and ranch mixture. And then we're ready to put our pasta into the Instant Pot. Once you get your chicken all shredded, we're gonna go ahead and add it to our cream cheese and ranch mixture. And then we're just gonna mix it all up. And then we're ready to get our pasta into our Instant Pot. The next step is we're gonna go ahead and take our water. So since I have the recipe, I halved the water. So this is only 1 1/2 cups of water. To that, we're gonna go ahead and add in our 8 ounces of pasta. And then on top of our pasta is where we're gonna go ahead and add in our chicken mixture. So we're just going to scoop it on top of our actual pasta in our Instant Pot. And then we'll get ready to cook it just a little bit longer. So I've added my chicken, cream cheese, ranch mixture to the top of my noodles. I did add just a tiny bit of hot sauce as well. So then we are going to put our lid on and we are going to again set our Instant Pot on manual, but this time we're only going to do it for 4 minutes, and that is enough time to cook down the pasta. So I just took the lid off of the Instant Pot. Yum, look at that. Ooh, sorry, we're gonna get kind of steamy for a second. But basically I'm just going to stir the chicken mixture in with our noodles. Let me wipe you off. There we go. Stir the chicken in with our noodles, and then I'm going to just go ahead and top it with our cheese. So I did decide to use all of the cheese, which is 4 ounces of the light shredded cheese. So I'm just going to put that on top. And the best way to melt the cheese, if you don't want to go a whole nother pan route, sorry, there we go, is to just put your Instant Pot lid on for just a few minutes, give the cheese a chance to melt. I'll plate this up and show you dinner. Look at this dinner. Look at that cheesy, creamy deliciousness. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this plated up. 1/6 of this is a serving. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that on my plate, and I will show you what a serving size looks like and give you the smart points. But look at this, yummy. So here is dinner, yum, look at this. So I went ahead and topped it with 1/2 tablespoon of these real bacon bits. That is 0 points for 1/2 tablespoon. So what I have here is 1/6 of our buffalo chicken pasta. Look at this cheesy pasta, bacony deliciousness. So that is a total of 6 smart points. So 1/6 of the recipe, 6 smart points. And then we're just having some broccoli and cauliflower with a little bit of spray butter, salt, and pepper. So this entire dinner is a total of 6 smart points. For tonight's dinner, we are making Instant Pot teriyaki chicken. I am making quite a few modifications to the original recipe. The original recipe wants you to make your own teriyaki. I'm going to use a pre-bought one because it is 0 points. Other than that, our recipe is going to be the same. So this is very simple, super quick. Let me show you what's in tonight's dinner. So of course you're going to need chicken breast. The recipe calls for thighs, but I'm going to go ahead and use chicken breast. We're also going to need either some ground ginger or fresh ginger, cornstarch, garlic. I'm gonna go ahead and just use this dried garlic. I bought this at Costco. It just really makes it a lot easier and lasts a very long time. And I'm actually gonna use Jihyo sugar-free teriyaki marinade instead of making my own. This will save a lot of steps, and this marinade is 0 points. It's only 5 calories for a tablespoon. And then of course we're going to need some rice. So let's get started on tonight's dinner. So the first thing we need to do is go ahead and add your chicken to a Ziploc bag. We are then going to add in our teriyaki marinade. It does want this to marinate for about 20 minutes. I'm going to add about 1/2 of the bottle. I think that that's plenty for my 3 chicken breasts. So I'm gonna get this kind of mixed together, and I'm gonna throw this into the fridge while we put together the rest of our ingredients and get our Instant Pot out. So the first thing you are going to do is place your chicken with your teriyaki sauce into your Instant Pot. Look at how delicious that looks. To this, we are going to be adding in a little bit of ginger. Now again, you can use fresh ginger or ground ginger. So I decided just to go ahead and top it with just a little bit of ginger. This marinade is going to be super flavorful, so we don't need to go too crazy on the seasoning. And then I'm also going to add in a little bit of my lighthouse garlic as well, just to kind of give it that little extra boost of garlicky goodness. And then from here, we are going to take the steamer rack for our Instant Pot. So this is what it looks like. And we're actually going to place it on top of our chicken. And then you're going to need a dish that will be safe in your Instant Pot. And you're going to place it on top of the steamer rack. To your dish is where we're gonna go ahead and add in our 1 cup of rice. And then we are also going to be adding in our water. So we wanna make sure that our rice is fully covered in water, and then we are ready to get this going. So we're gonna put our lid on and we'll get it started. So to cook our chicken and rice, we're actually going to use the manual button, and we wanna go ahead and cook it for 6 minutes on high pressure. And then once it is done cooking for 6 minutes, we're going to naturally release it for 10. So I'll be back in about 6 minutes. Once your 6 minutes is up, your Instant Pot is automatically going to natural release. So we wanna do that for 10 minutes. So this dial will read 10, and then we will release the rest of the pressure and take a look at tonight's dinner. Once your Instant Pot reads 10 minutes of natural release, we're just gonna go up here and turn this and vent out any remaining steam, which it does not look like there's any, and then we'll remove the lid and take a look at our dinner. So there is our rice, it is perfectly done. I'm gonna use my little silicone mitt that came in my accessory pack for my Instant Pot, which I purchased on Amazon. It is linked down in my Amazon store. There is our rack, so we're gonna get that removed, and I'm actually going to shred up my chicken in the teriyaki sauce. Once you get your chicken shredded, this is where you can add in some cornstarch to thicken your teriyaki, but I'm pretty good with the thickness of it, and I do want it to kind of drizzle over my rice. So I'm gonna go ahead and plate up my chicken and teriyaki and my rice, and I'll show you the completed meal and give you the smart points. So here is tonight's dinner. This looks delicious. So first I just have some organic mixed veggies. I just sprayed those with a little bit of, I can't believe it's not butter spray, salt and pepper, so that is zero. Then over here is my teriyaki chicken. So what I have is 1/2 cup cooked of white rice. So that is a total of 3 smart points. I did just go ahead and measure that here just using 1/2 cup per serving. So I have 1/2 cup of white rice for 3. And then I topped it with my teriyaki chicken, a little bit of the teriyaki sauce. That is 0. So this entire dinner is a total of 3 smart points. Teriyaki, chicken and rice, and veggies for 3 points. Thank you for joining me on the 3rd episode in my WW Instant Pot series. I hope that you enjoyed seeing the 2 recipes that I shared with you. They were both phenomenal. So make sure that if you have an Instant Pot, you definitely make these recipes. If you do not, it is time to purchase one because these recipes were so good. I do have several Instant Pots linked down in the description box in my Amazon store, so check them out. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new, make sure you subscribe, hit the little notification bell, that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Give this one a thumbs up, comment down below, let me know, are you gonna try these 2 recipes, or have I convinced you to get an Instant Pot? And I'll see you guys all in the next one. Bye.